Thank you. is going to be way too loud for you.
Thank you very much. It's really, really good to be back. I do remember that last year was insanely hot, so I'm very grateful that instead it's a little bit less hot and there are lots of mosquitoes. It's a bit like, well, I feel quite at home here. It's a bit like Holland. Right, well, we started off with This Can't Be Love, which was composed by all means. Yes. Do you know that?
Rodgers and Hart.
Was it?
I think so.
No.
Rodgers and Hammerstein?
Something Rodgers, maybe Roy Rodgers.
Rodgers Hornsby. Roy Rodgers.
And after that we played a song called After You've Gone, which maybe you shouldn't take too seriously right now, but I'd like it to stay here. We have a nice collection of songs for you tonight that we don't know very well. But they're going to come after the next one. So the next one will be a song that we do, well, at least pretend to know very well. It's a very, very beautiful song. It's one of my favorite songs. It was written by Hoagy Carmichael. And it's called The Nearness of You.
F, right?
Yes. Thank you. This is one I'm not very familiar with, coming up. Good luck, everybody.
Paul was talking about extraordinary fiddling, and so we thought we probably should have an actual fiddle song. Would that be okay if we played a fiddle tune?
Yeah.
American fiddle tune?
You don't know what you're saying.
We all know this one. It's Liberty. And we're going to play Liberty and take some liberties with Liberty.
Yes, we will do that. Yes, we'll take it. Thank you. Microphone is being
maybe another piece of tape.
So while you fix that mic, I can tell you guys just which about the next tune. We are here as tutors and performers in this Django Reinhardt extravaganza camp, where it's very camp, isn't it? Django Reinhardt. Anyway, it's a summer school. I'll call it a summer school. Makes it sound a bit more serious than it really is. And we play and teach the music of Django Reinhardt, which is now called Gypsy Jazz. And he was this guy in the 1930s who lost the use of two of his fingers. And as a guitarist, that's rather unfortunate. But what he did was he just came up with a way of using only the thumb and the two strong fingers to make new chords. So his handicap became his strength, and he was one of the great innovators of jazz guitar. He's probably the biggest name that guitarists would refer to as their main influence.
Unsurpassed to this day.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, even people like Joe Satriani and Stevie Vai and all those rock guys, I think they were all in Santana. You know Carlos Santana? Is he famous over here? Okay, yeah. Well, they all cite Django as one of their main influences, which is incredible for a guy in the 1930s, who lived until 1953. Anyway, so one of his tunes we're going to play you now. It's called Douce Ambiance, which means... I'm glad we did the talking during that pickup truck. It means happy atmosphere. I think that sums up what we have here. Well, at least we're very happy. We hope you're happy too. Good. Douce Ambiance, written by Django Reinhardt in 19...
Yes.
That's right, isn't it?
It is.
Yeah. Good.
Exactly right.
Were you going to call this one?
I think so.
Yeah, I think so too.
You were going to play your famous Latin groovalicious.
Okay. Good. Okay, well, Don and I have been talking about this for ages, you know, since 7 o'clock tonight. And there is a song he sings, and I said, oh, that sounds nice. And he said, are you sure? So I said, no. So it's been on and off the set list, but we've decided to put it on, because I think you should hear Don sing. In fact, I think I should hear Don sing as well. And this song is called I Thought About You. Is that correct?
That is correct.
I'm honored. So, could you get that microphone there and sing into that? Even though it's not amplified. It's...
Y'all know Johnny Mercer, the great songwriter? This is one of his lyrics, and with music by another of the all-time great songwriters, Jimmy Van Heusen.
Oh, yes. Did you know where he got his name from, Jimmy Van Heusen?
He
was called Charles Babcock.
Really?
He was from Scotland, and Jimmy Van Heusen was a shirt make that they saw in the store in New York. That's how he got his name, his stage name.
Wow.
Sorry for that completely useless bit of information. I took all the flow out of his announcement as well.
No, it's fine. So a selection, ladies and gentlemen, by Johnny Mercer and Charles Babcock. That was really his
name?
Yeah. Why would anybody give up a name like that? I took a trip on a train. And I thought about you. I passed a shadowy lane. And I thought about you. Two or three cars were parked under the stars by a winding stream. Moon shining down on some little town. With each beam I had the same old dream. At every stop that we made, well, I thought about you. And when I pulled down the shade, then I really felt blue. I peeked through the crack and looked down at the track, the one leading back to you. And what did I do? I thought about you. Thank you. every stop that we made, well, I thought about you. And when I pulled down the shade, then I really felt blue. I peeked through the crack and looked down at the track, the one leading back to you. And what did I do? What did I do? What did I do? I thought about you.
Well, that was not too bad.
I know other songs.
Well, that's. I think that's it was just great just the way it was. So, we do have another tune, and then we're going to have a little break in which we're going to get some new air in and eat some watermelon, I've been told. And for those of you who are interested in some CDs, there'll be some CDs for sale over there as well. And also an email list for those who didn't hear about this concert and are consequently not there. Please put your name down on the list there, because it really works. You'll be there next time. So thank you for that. What's going on there? Is she okay, you think? Oh, there's another one there. We're going to finish this set with a song called, it's a very old song, it's called Shine. Deep breath. Thank you. So, for those who like gypsy jazz, they know that this style was initiated in the 1930s by Django Reinhardt and Stefan Grappelli. And for me, of course, Stefan Grappelli, the violin player in that band, was instrumental in getting me to sort of understand how to improvise on a violin as an instrument. I'd heard many modern day jazz fiddlers and I didn't really understand what they were doing, but with Stefan I thought, oh yeah, I can understand this. So we'll play you two Django Reinhardt, Stefan Grappelli compositions. So they were co-composers people on these tunes. Composers, that's what they're called, co-composers. You see, when you get from here from Holland, the jet lag's always, it catches up around mid show time, so that's right. So we'll play you these two tunes. One's called Swing 42, and the other one is called Belleville. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was the Tennessee Waltz. This is our travelogue set, I think, this time. Looking at the set list, we went to Belleville for a little bit there, and then we went over down to Tennessee, and we're going to keep heading south and go down to Brazil. Would you like to go to Brazil for just a I would say for just a few moments, but I think we all know at this point it's going to be a little bit longer time than that, because we'd like to get into it a little bit. Brazil. Oh, yeah. Thank you. I like to play that song because the hit version of that in the United States was by the great singer Carmen Miranda. She was in the movies, right? Wasn't she the one that she sang on it? She had the giant. It was like a whole structure on her head of bananas, I think. Like.
A little bit like Lady Gaga, then.
I like to do songs like that that have anything at all to do with something on the top of your head.
You do seem to need that, Dom.
Yeah. Well, you know, we were going to try the watermelons. It didn't quite work out. Speaking of that, between the combination of my hairstyle and the strong new lights, I hope nobody's getting hurt in the front. Yeah, I'm so excited to play with Tim, I forget to put camouflage on there. So, have we come to that time, Tim?
I think it's kind of the last tune, isn't it?
Well, going by our prepared list, yes.
Yeah. So we do need to thank you all for being here, because it's such a wonderful haven you get here.
Oh,
from this great madness, the urban complete craziness of Northampton, and you just relax after that. It's wonderful.
Do we really have to go back?
I don't think so.
Just kidding.
And also a big thanks to Paul, because Paul and Claudia, because they're hosting endless sessions here of really great musicians. I mean, Martin Hayes, I met him in Belfast and in Baltimore in Ireland, I think, and he's just an amazing fiddler. So if you've not got tickets for that one, you definitely should.
Is Dennis Cahill going to be with
him? No, he's not with him.
Oh, then don't book tickets, sorry. No, that's true. Has he got a mandolin player, though?
Not yet.
Oh. Don? I feel a call coming up. We're hoping that we can kind of use the recorded material of tonight in some way, either by making it available to you through little sort of, well, the local network are going to possibly help with that. But if we're very lucky, we could try and make that into some kind of small CD. But it depends on us, doesn't it, really, Don?
Well, it does depend on us, but we should all also thank Eric Kilburn.
Yes, and that's why we have to thank Eric for recording tonight. Thank you very much, Eric.
I should say that many, if not most, of the shows this summer and last summer will be online, available for streaming. So you go
for streaming? That's wonderful. No more singing, Don. I'm hearing. Right. Time for our final tune. Without further ado.
Please be seated, ladies and gentlemen. We'd like to ask you to now turn off your hymnals.
And turn off your cell phones. Okay, well, you've done it again. Well, there's one tune we can play.
Yeah.
The one of the beautiful ballads out there. It's called Nuage, Django Reinhardt.
We're just having a band meeting here.
Yeah, sorry.
First item of business is to